Friends, there will come a point in your data career where you have to move beyond technology and understand how you talk to business, because that will get you into the boardrooms, that will get you into the executive positions in the data industry. While you can be doing really well in your data career, being a data engineer or a data analyst, if you want to move to the next level, you have to understand the 6-step data strategy framework, which I'll be giving an overview of today. And I personally call it the LAATIS framework. So this is not a technical video. So if you are here to deploy some Python libraries and pandas, guys, this is not the video. I won't waste your time. But if you are someone who wants to go to that level where you understand what works behind the scenes, what makes a data solution really successful, then you have to understand the strategy part of it. So let's understand. I'll try to dissect it, and maybe we can also take a use case, a random use case. I don't have anything in my mind right now, but we'll see how we progress. Okay, so let's start with our, you know, basic data carriers. So imagine this is your data carrier, and you will start maybe somewhere as a data analyst or data engineer. Then you can also become a data architect. So you progress like this, okay? But there would come a point, so it could be 2 years, 6 to 8 years here, and then 15 years. There will come a point where you will start understanding the nuances of a data strategy and why data strategy is so important. And we will understand that there will come a point where you will start understanding that you have to move beyond tools and talk strategy. So what is strategy? Strategy is what you execute to solve a problem. Okay, so you work on a strategy. That strategy could be anything. It could be applied in any area of your life. For example, if you are right now struggling to find a job, your strategy could be to understand what's missing in your resume, or maybe understanding what colleagues of you yours are doing better than you as far as the job search is concerned. What is this? This is a strategy. You're trying to solve a problem. So in a similar manner, the LAATIS framework, which we will now talk about, gives you that structure that when you go to the business, you don't start jumping. So one thing which is a huge problem in our industry is that when we meet business, so imagine this is a business. He's angry because of his bad performance or whatever. And then you come in here and you say, I will solve your problems. Okay. And you say, okay, tell me if you like to use Python or Azure data pipeline. No, big no. You don't talk like this. Business don't understand your language. This is a big no-no. As a senior data consultant, what you will do, you will apply the LAATIS framework, which we will now talk about. And we will take an analogy of a doctor. So this is the LAATIS framework, guys. Okay, let's go through it one by one. So we have to think like a doctor. Whenever you go to a doctor, he not just pulls you into an operation theater and asks you to just lie down so that he can open your stomach and get you fixed. Okay, so first of all, in any, while building any data strategy, the most important point is listening. Okay. It is the most important point, guys, because you have to understand what business problem you are dealing with. So listen very carefully. So whenever you are meeting the business, first of all, you have to understand, boss, what is the problem? Why they have even called us for this meeting? Okay. Now, in order to understand the business problem, you also need a bit of domain knowledge, but that is separate. That will come while working on different solutions. But imagine that you have gone to a doctor. The first thing which doctor starts asking you is about your symptoms, what you are feeling, where exactly is the pain, where you are feeling pain. Then he will also ask what you ate yesterday. Do you have any allergies? All these kind of things. So what you are right now doing is you are probing. Okay. You are probing. You're trying to understand what is the problem which the business is facing. Generally, what happens, guys, that whenever business calls you for anything to solve a data problem, they are not expecting a technical debate or a technical discussion. They are basically focusing on either increasing revenue or they might be worried about their cost, so they want to decrease cost or maybe increase their efficiency or ROI, whatever. It could be anything. So you have to first of all listen, and you don't have to listen to one person. You have to talk to different stakeholders. Okay, so take for example that let's take a random example. It might add value to your knowledge. So take for example, there is a university, XYZ university, which is on the verge of closure because this university is not getting enough enrollment. There no one is enrolling. And while they have the best in class things, everything, the course, the curriculum, everything, they're not understanding. So you will go to the business, you will talk to the VP of enrollment, you might talk to the head of technology, you might talk to students, and you will try to understand what could be the possible problem. So for VP, there could be a separate problem. For head of technology, different problem. For students, different problem. These are your stakeholders. After talking to them, you will find out, okay, what are the top three burning problems I need to solve? For example, okay, so find out root cause of low enrollment, increase enrollment by 50%. I'm just giving random examples, guys, okay? So all this you will do, and then you will identify and establish a business problem statement. Once the business problem statement has been identified and it has got a nod from the business, then you move to the step two, and the step two of this becomes the analysis phase. So you analyze, okay, why the problem exists. Here is when, after listening to all everything, doctor will start to analyze why you are facing, what could be the possible root causes, which we also call as root cause analysis, okay, RCA. That analysis might need further involvement, and now this is coming a point where you will start diving into data. So you might be, you know, you might ask the university team to show what kind of marketing strategy they are using right now. Is it a marketing problem? You will start building a kind of a hypothesis. Okay, this hypothesis could be that, okay, if everything is good based on whatever I have discussed, why people are not choosing it? Is it a marketing problem? And if that hypothesis is you are building on, then you will understand whatever data you can get for you for the university's marketing strategy. During that analysis, you might find out that, you know, the marketing budget which is being given is heavily spent on traditional marketing like newspapers, okay, or TV ads, but there is no budget for digital marketing. But considering the generation which we are dealing with is more using Facebook or Insta or YouTube, okay, so based on this hypothesis, you might want to come up with a solution. And now at this point of time, doctor has kind of done its analysis and now wants to talk about the problem, like what solution we are talking about, okay, what kind of solution we might have to implement. So this is the point where now you will talk about the application of a strategic solution. When we say strategic solution means that we are not very sure right now whether it will work or not. I am just testing. Okay, I'm just thinking that, okay, let's apply this strategic solution. And that strategic solution could be to, now comes the actual test, because now what will happen, now the actual data solution will come into picture. What data solution you are building, okay? This data solution could be an end-to-end digital marketing campaign, okay? So now you might be building your architectures also here. At a high level, you will be building your data architecture. So you might be, you might then ask your architects to come up with a solution that, okay, what kind of data we will need, what kind of analysis we will perform on that data, and then based on that output, what kind of marketing strategy we will implement, okay? So now here technology comes in. But if you see in the first two sections, we did not even touch technology. So technology does have a role to play, but it only is handy when you know what is the problem. So no one will give you a paracetamol right at the beginning of your right when you enter doctor's cabin. Okay, so that is the biggest problem, guys, that holds us get into senior roles, because we dwell too much into technology. When you are talking about pre-sales, you talk about business strategy or data strategy, you have to first think of the problem. And I think if you can spend most of your time in the first two steps, rest of the steps will be much more efficient. So now you have come with something in your head and you have built a kind of a solution which you think might help. Okay, this solution is taking the data from all the university artifacts, documents, repository, different data from from Twitter, from LinkedIn, about what's happening, what is the target audience, what students are looking for in the curriculum, all that is now with you. And now what you are doing is you are putting it into maybe a machine learning model or maybe a LLM model, and you are trying to generate very targeted, very specific campaigns, and you want to collect those data points, and you want to you want to generate those campaigns which will then be rolled out by the marketing team in different areas. So the marketing team will be the consumer of this data. I'm just making it on the fly, guys. So I have not prepared for this case study. What I'm thinking is on the fly. So it might not be ideal, but you understand what happens, okay, at every step. So in the lattice framework, the third step which comes up, the fourth step, let's talk about the fourth step. So the fourth step is testing. So what the doctor does, tells you that okay, let's take this medicine 3 days once every 6 hours, and then come back. Always doctor say come back and tell me how you are feeling. So that is what is pilot validation or testing, where we will be building a MVP solution, which is called as a minimum viable product. Minimum viable product, okay? Because we have to understand whether our hypothesis is correct or not. So maybe what we can do is, during the pilot validation or MVP phase, we will be targeting that for this particular university, the marketing campaign which we are building will only target a particular course in a particular area, geography. Okay, so very, very targeted. We want to say we want to know that for this particular course or curriculum, based on whatever data we have got, whatever data intelligence we have got so far, are we able to increase the enrollments? Okay, once this hypothesis is validated, which is like, okay, yes, it is doing well, it is working fine, then obviously now you will think about one more thing which I forgot to add here is that you will do what is called as A/B testing, alpha beta testing. So A/B testing means that you will use one particular solution, and then you will compare it with your original solution and see the efficacy of which is performing better. So that is called as A/B testing. Now once that is done, now comes the point where we will be saying that, okay boss, now we have done enough of our R&D, let's try to deploy this, a rollout. So doctor would say, okay, I have tested it in 5 patients and all these 5 patients are giving me positive results, so I'm going to roll out this kind of a treatment to all my patients more or less having the same kind of symptoms. So I'm just giving a analogy, but at a university level it would be a full rollout across geography, location, courses, etc., etc. Okay, this would be a full rollout which will be then done based on the validation. Okay, once this particular full rollout is successful and we are seeing the result, then after that we will be doing it at a much bigger level. So once we have validated that, okay, this does work, the scaling means that now you will be broadening the your area, your circumference of this strategy. So maybe you went to one university and you applied it, but now because it works, you can basically create this strategy and scale it to different universities across countries, because you have now tested it, implemented it, and it is giving you results. So thing is, the business strategy is important, not technology. So what is important is the impact, business impact. So if you can make business impact, then there's all the point in implementing all the fancy data tools, be it Panda, be it Spark, be it Snowflake, be it everything, okay, Scala, Everything, whatever you are doing, BigQuery, Redshift, whatever you're talking right now, okay? Everything makes sense if it boils down to solving business problems. And as you will grow in your career, you will identify and you will realize that how important it is. Right now also, let me give you some more insights. So right now also, as we are approaching this era of LLMs, machine learning, everything, okay? You understand one concept, bad data equates to bad model. Simple, period. Okay, I would stretch it even further. Bad listening leads to bad understanding of the problem, leading to bad data strategy, leading to bad data solution equals to bad model, and then finally all this boils down to bad results. So no matter how good you are with your tools and technologies as a company, if you're not able to understand and decipher the business problems, then you will always be suffering. So I just thought of bringing this in front of you, because if you are very early in your career, these things might not be explained to you, because there would be some suited people sitting in some big rooms talking about all this while you are coding your data pipelines. But this will eventually come to you, and if you know it now, it will much make you sound so smarter in the room. Okay, think about business, think about problems, and then whatever technology you are working on will work like magic. That is my guarantee. I hope this was a useful video. Let me know if you want these kind of videos, guys. And also let me know in the comments if you are liking this kind of a whiteboarding session, guys, because the problem is my physical whiteboard, you are very used to seeing me on the physical whiteboard drawing things. But now the challenge with that is I have a very limited space to explain things, and that creates a lot of challenges for me. So if you like this kind of an approach, then please give the thumbs up, give the likes, let me know in the comments your feedback, and maybe I will try to use this also as a part of my delivery method for my tutorials. So until next time, keep learning, keep sharing, and keep growing. Bye for now.